Okay, so yeah, talking about the national team, you played again with Dawn Macandili, who you won three championships in LaSalle with. How was it like for you to be, you know, with her again in the national team naman this time?
Sobrang ano, sobrang thankful ako nandun sila Ate Dawn, Ate Kianna, sila Ate Abby, at si Ate Joy. Kasi sobrang ginaid talaga nila ako. Like, I was scared, pero palagi nila akong ano, nire-reassure na you earned your spot. Just play your best. Yun, ganun. Tapos, they also guided me sa yung how things are run dun sa team. And kung paano maki ano sa coaches kasi sobrang ako introverted ako na tao, hindi ako yung mismong mag-aano. Sabi si Ate Abby talaga din and si Ate Don, parang si Ate Don in regards to sa training, sa kasi siya yung roommate ko, so siya talaga yung naka-close ko sa ano, sa bubble. So especially ngayong COVID and everything so unsure, like siya yung naging comfort body ko if we got like anxiety from COVID situations, siya yung kaano ko, the comfort kasi sobrang, you know, you never know what's gonna happen sa dahil sa pandemic na to, so yeah.
Before the tournament started in Thailand, nag-iisip ako eh. Like I was asking then na ano kaya yung mas malakas na team no pag maglaban, Rebisco or Choco Mucho. And then eventually, naglaban nga kayo. And this was super unexpected. And like, I don't know how it is for the players, but for you, Tin, was it weird like na you went to that game and you know, you guys were haven't won yet, and then yung mga fans dito were already dying for a Filipino win, a Philippines team win. So what was it? What was the mindset for you guys when you played against each other in that match?
Oh, weird. Kasi nga, they're your teammates. And then, also, like, for standing din yun eh, for ranking. So, one of you will really be dropped. Kasi, kung si ano man yung outcome ng game. I think, also, yung mindset lang ng team namin was, tune-up to, ganun. Kasi, nakaka-tune-up naman namin sila. And, I think, yeah. It was weird playing against them. Kasi nga, parang ka-close mo din sila, pero you have yung pride mo as a player. Siyempre, ayaw mo din magpatalo.
Ayaw mo magpatalo pero may Abby Maranyo sa kabila.
Yeah. Ayaw din naman nila magpatalo, syempre, di ba? But, yun nga. I think it was a close game also. So, either one of us could have won. It's
Okay,
just
I want to ask
me.
this. Since you said that it was like a closely contested match, what did you think Choco Mucho had as an advantage over, you know, the Rebisco team?
I think nag-show yung maturity ng team namin. Kasi nga, there's more of us who have played PBL, college, sa Choco Mucho na side. Whereas sa Rebisco, fairly young yung mga players doon. And some of them haven't even played UAAP yet. And that's a big burden for like sa mga seniors like Ate Abby, Ate Ding, and sila Ate Gemma, and Ate Kiana, Ate Joy. Like, kasi they're surrounded by bagets. So, hindi pa nila masyado kasay yung skills nila. Whereas, yung sa amin, wala kaming baget sa team namin eh. So, everyone knew their role. Kaya, I
Oh,
think
ikaw na
yung
yung
maturity that...
pinaka-bagets. Ikaw na yung pinaka, like, bata sa
Si
team, right?
Angel. Si Angel. Kabatch ko siya, pero she's a year younger. Angel, kayo na.
Oh, really? I
Yeah.
thought Angel was older than you pa.
Yeah,
Interesting.
nagulat din ako. Kala ko nga, ka-age ko lang siya. Pero, mas bata pa pala siya
Thank you for watching Volleyball DNA. Make sure you hit the subscribe button to get notified for future episodes and interview highlights.
And while you're at it, head over to our Facebook page by clicking on the link in the description.